Strap in. This NordVPN features review is about to introduce you to every important feature of NordVPN and how to use them. So let's start with a question. What's the deal with this kill switch that every VPN has? This feature is the reason you can use unstable networks, such as public Wi-Fi, without worrying about your privacy. As long as the kill switch is active, any network disruption will cause your connection to be temporarily killed, preventing any data leaks. If you're planning to use a VPN only for some apps without changing your general connection, time to shift the attention of this NordVPN feature analysis a little bit below the kill switch. There you can find split tunneling. With this feature, I can use VPN for torrenting while also browsing without VPN at the same time. One major downside is that split tunneling is not available on iOS devices, not with NordVPN, not with any other VPN in general. Blame Apple for not giving you options for your connection. Talking about connection, I recommend enabling Auto Connect as part of your initial NordVPN setup. With Auto Connect, you can establish the connection immediately when launching HTE app or connecting to unsafe networks. For me, Auto Connect is only enabled on Wi-Fi connections, but you can change that with this drop-down menu and even configure to which server you want to connect automatically. Alternatively, you can just turn on the Quick Connect option to connect to the fastest server as soon as you launch the app. This option is less versatile but more convenient. That said, both Auto Connect and Quick Connect work only when you launch the app. So, how to use NordVPN as soon as your device launches? This is possible because of the auto launch setting. You can see right here that the app can be launched alongside my Windows PC, and I can even choose if I want it to pop up immediately or get minimized and hidden in the system tray instead. That's pretty convenient. Though when it comes to convenience, I like to be able to choose between different presets, like for streaming, browsing, optimal speeds, and so on. With NordVPN, the presets features does exactly that. By providing a list of system presets for anything you are planning to do with your VPN. Unfortunately, this feature is a Mac OS exclusive. I guess it's a way for NordVPN to apologize for not having split tunneling on iOS. This is more or less everything you can configure on the settings menu. Time to go back to the main screen and take a look at the NordVPN features hidden there. NordVPN calls them specialty servers, and they all have their uses. Even though these servers can't use all the available NordVPN locations. Some websites, like banking ones, don't like when their users log in with different IP addresses every time. A dedicated IP can help with that, providing you with a server that has the same IP every time, helping you avoid any suspicions. In case if you feel like you need extra protection and a second VPN begins to feel like a good idea, double VPN is just the thing. Double VPN routes a connection through two servers at once, thus capitalizing on the benefits of a twice encrypted connection. And if your country cracks down on privacy software and you feel like you need to use obfuscated servers, they are created to bypass any VPN blocking firewalls by making your connection look like it's a casual connection without a VPN. Of course, there's no better way of ensuring privacy than running your connection through three randomly chosen nodes around the world, throwing off any tracking attempt. That's what the Onion router is for. And the Onion over VPN servers help to combine VPN with Tor. Together, these servers provide a very safe connection, which is borderline impossible to hack or track. Unfortunately, this also makes the connection very slow, so use this feature at your own risk. Finally, if you are a torrenting fan and you always wanted to have the best P2P speed while also not revealing your ISP you are torrenting, there are P2P specialty servers. My performance with them was top-notch. Finally, this NordVPN review has to mention three prominent features with separate tabs in the app. For instance, Threat Protection. This feature is a bona fide built-in antivirus. It can be configured to block all ads, trackers, malicious websites, and even malware. This feature doesn't even require a VPN connection. It's always active in the background. Unless, of course, you enable the light mode, forcing Threat Protection to only work when you are connected to a VPN. Next to Threat Protection, there's a feature that can build a secure LAN connection between multiple devices, whether for business or entertainment purposes. This is Meshet, a new NordVPN feature that you can use to access other devices in your created secure LAN network and safely share files through an encrypted connection. Finally, if you are worried that any of your data could have been leaked on a dark web, there's a feature that can monitor this and notify you whenever your personal details are compromised. It's literally called a dark web monitor too. What a coincidence. And for those who missed the memo, this video is part of my NordVPN review series. You can find the full NordVPN review through the link in the top right corner. Though I have listed so many things in this NordVPN features review, you might not need them all. I would argue that a kill switch, threat protection, and auto-connect your online experience would be much safer. But after this video, even if you don't use these features, you can at least explain what is Meshnet to all your friends. Thanks for watching this far, and don't forget to check the link in the description to grab NordVPN with an exclusive discount.